Don't you look handsome? You know, we are definitely the hottest couple in the woman behind the man feature.
Because I was really worried about that.
How's my hair?
It's beautiful.
Okay,
you look great.
Makeup done, accessories, ring, table behind you.
Ring! Right.
Here.
What is this?
Put it on. Relax, it's just a prop.
Oh, because he told the editor that we were engaged, right?
Yeah, romance sells magazines.
Of course.
Glamorous.
Okay. Yes.
We look fabulous, you know, yes. And that is a good choice of tie because it goes with my dress and I'm the woman behind the man.
And I'm the accessory behind the woman.
Here, help me with my coat.
Yes, of course. Gotcha.
This is exciting.
Yes, it is. I haven't been this excited since I isolated the compound that inhibits key receptors in cells.
What?
Nothing, just that research that I did. The thing that makes you the woman that I'm the man behind, or is it the other way around?
Matt,
I always get that confused.
I think you're extremely brilliant, and you have made an amazing discovery that's going to help tons of people. I'm really proud of you.
Yes. And what was that discovery? Here, I'll help you. It'll be like a multiple choice question. Tooth whitening, oncology, hair implants.
Say them again? I'm kidding. It's for cancer research of some sort. I'm not that stupid.
I didn't say that. I just, you know, sometimes, you know, if you're the lack of interest.
No,
or the
I'm
level
very
of interest
interested.
Or...
I've just been so busy lately, you know, but I set up this photo shoot, didn't I? To celebrate all your accomplishments. I mean, when this hits the stands, millions of people are going to know what I know, that you are a brilliant, dedicated doctor who is all about saving lives.
How?
How what?
How am I that brilliant, dedicated doctor that's going to save lives?
The receptors thing that you just... We talked the receptors.
If you're the woman behind the man, don't you think you should know?
Oh, my God, you're right. Go.
What do you mean, go? What are you doing?
I'm making a crib sheet. Haven't you ever... Come on.
Yeah, okay, all right. Lay, what was the journal that I was published in?
Cancer Monthly?
Medical Research Review. Let's go.
Almost passed out.
Wait, it was so hot underneath those lights.
Hello? I was hot too.
Are you okay? You have better circulation than I do.
I moved around, shifted positions, you know, did some stretches in between shots, which is what I told you to do too.
Well, excuse me, I'm not a model.
Yeah, well, it's not brain surgery.
Correct. That is absolutely right. It's the first time you've been right about anything medical related all evening. I mean, if you could have just remembered some of the things that we talked about, then we wouldn't have to sit there with our
faces all smiling.
That you
spilled water all over
smiling.
My hand and ruined my crib sheet.
What are you talking about?
I mean, right before you fell on the ground.
Oh, it's not that bad.
Yeah, you know what? You just better thank me that I pinched you before you ruined your pretty face.
Okay, all right. I'll give you that. You did help me from making a complete fool of myself.
Yeah, well, you're welcome.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, now it's your turn to thank me.
For what?
For helping you with all those questions. You were petrified during that Q&A. I had to feed you all the answers.
Maybe a few.
Yeah, I was just lobbing them up for you.
Mm-hmm. Well, you were very sweet and charming.
Yes, I can be like that sometimes. What was it that the photographer said about us?
He said that we had good chemistry.
Oh, yeah.
So let's talk about you moving in. I'm not trying to pressure you. It's just that, you know, I'm living alone, and while an attractive woman attracts unwanted attention.
And I have every confidence that you could handle any jerk who catcalls.
Well, what about the guy who's stalking me? I mean, what about the fedora guy? Give me a second. You never called to finalize me about the final flower arrangements. Why? Oh, God, the bride hasn't been... victim of an accident, has she? Okay, fine. I'll rearrange, but this makes us even. Yes? Yes, it does. Look, I'm kind of busy right now, so I'll call you back later.
What was that all about?
Just a wedding I'm working on, you know, a really hush-hush wedding, very VIP couple.
Uh-huh.
So, back to you moving in, huh? I'm gonna take this out of the picture, so.
Look, I just think you're lonely and you're missing Lulu.
I do really miss her.
Yeah.
But on the other hand, you know, she was really sloppy and I don't miss her stuff being strewn all about.
Right? Her stuff would get everywhere and you know, you replace her with me, my stuff is just gonna be invading your space.
It wouldn't.
Well, yeah, you gotta trust me on this. I'm not the cleanest.
Okay, Matt, look, the thing is, I'm really nervous living here, you know? I mean, this neighborhood isn't exactly gentrified.
Brian, okay, I want you to be safe and protected, okay? I want to be clear on that.
Okay.
But this whole step of moving in together, I mean, it's a big thing, you know? I would have to get rid of my apartment, and we would have to understand that we want to take this relationship to the next level.
Well, of course this relationship might move to the next level. I mean, that's always been a possibility.
Yeah, no, I know. I just want it to be for the right reasons. That's all.
I don't want it to be for the... I mean, I want it to be for the right reasons. You know. Oh, my God, there's the fedora guy. Look. He's right there.
Where are you looking? I don't see anyone. There's...
He was.
What? Where?
He was right there, Matt.
Okay. I have to get to work.
But you have to believe
my
me. Look.
Real job.
Look, I'm not making up the fedora guy in order to get you to move in.
Okay, that's fine.
No, I really need you to believe me, okay? I'm not being paranoid. I don't feel safe.
Listen, lock the door behind me. I will call you as soon as I get off work, okay?